Alright. Where we go? This way?
No.
This way?
Yes.
Alright. So you hammer guys are knocking down this stuff. So by the time we get back to town, we'll start getting more bunnies. Hey, stop trying to kill the stuff. Alright, so immediately chop down these trees. Immediately. Let's see what else we got. Ooh, that's useful. We'll get it on the way back. On the next day. Or something. There's no way we're going to build like giant stuff on the first day. It's gonna be nearly impossible. Signing back. It's your job, signing back. Oh, and this is the way of the mountain. So all the portals on the other side. That's what it's pretty much showing me. There is 3 portals on this map. 2 on one side, 1 on the other. The one on the other is the one between the mountain. So that means the portal, the 2 portals and the dock are the opposite way. So we have to go through 2 portals. Before we can get to the dock. He really wants to be an engineer. Let's see what we have over here. Plenty of space. Ooh, money. So these guys. If there's another undead horse upgrade on this side, I'll be very upset. No, there's just another treasure chest. I think the treasure chests are placeholders for things that you would unlock. There's a second portal. We knew about that. There's the map upgrade. They're still dedicated telling me, hey, you need to go upgrade. And I'm like, no. I don't want to upgrade. This is a no upgrade run. No upgrades. The only upgrade we're allowed is whatever they give me from the start of the game. The undead horse was from the start of the game. We didn't do any upgrade maps, unlockables. So technically, this undead horse is not unlockable. Or so I'm saying. You all can put down your comments what you think down below if you actually watch this and tell me if I'm wrong or I'm right or what you think this challenge should have been told, considering that I'm only doing this based off the comments for this game. They didn't say anything about not actually having anything like specific. So I'm saying this is fair game. Now, did everyone make it back? I don't want to see you guys walking. Alright, it looks like everyone made it. I want to destroy that portal, I think. No. Because there's plenty of walls right there. We're gonna have to knock down the... This for now. Once we get as much bunnies as possible. We may just do the same thing we did last time. Just keep it as minimal as possible on this side. Okay. And then we'll worry about, getting rid of some of the guys. But we have, like, I think it was, like, three camps out on the far left, so we can afford to we can afford getting rid of the camp on the right now, but we don't want to do that until we start getting rid of those portals. Because right now we need to recruit as many people as possible. Two people to get rid of the portals easily and quickly. So right now they're still giving us a decent amount of money. So we don't have to worry about that right now. Because not like, well, we're around money touch soon. We're not in that situation. That's the noise that makes. We already upgraded the shrine so we can get the three big walls as soon as possible. Let's just knock down this. I think we'll use our 2 coins to give them to the guys immediately, like right here. Yes. Oh no, you went home. I'm like, oh no, no, no. Oh no. Okay, the coin. I didn't see it happen. I knew you weren't going to grab that one. I just knew it. You can't be trusted. None of you can be trusted. Except for you, Philip. I'm going to let you guys decide on who Philip is. And this is the reason why I got so many engineers, like, quickly on. I'm gonna probably need that many engineers anyway. Because some will need to carry the boat. Or push the boat. So, it's also so they can quickly build up this town. So that I don't have to worry about certain things. You know, we have enough, like, military now to go into California. And since we're all really upgraded, we don't have to make much. Can you go out anymore? No. And I don't want to grab another guy right now because we'll just get eaten. So what I want to do is grab this. Grab this tower and this one with this wall. Maybe this wall too. This way, when the knights fall back, they can have two archer towers. No, I think just right here is fine. Always keep one available, just in case one guy loses his weapon. We could put a wall right there and then a thing right there. And keep all the farmers right there safe. Or we can just go destroy the portal. Don't worry about it. Right now we can't even send out the guys because we don't have a secondary. And if I have it too far out, then we'll lose some of the villagers. And that's as far out as we can go. Which means all I want to do is grab this one right here. That's all I want to do. I don't want to go anymore. I don't want to send out the knights until I know everyone's highly defended. Oh no, we ran out of money. You're not defending a kingdom here. Oh, that made me feel like such egotistical, like, you're not the one defending a kingdom, even though they're easily, like, defend, like, doing all the work, and I'm just sitting here tossing money at my problems. This guy's a prime example of who not to be his leader. Because you want to give the proper respect to your team. You don't want to be like, oh, well, I do all the work. I have the money, so I do all the work. No. That's not how you lead. That's not how you rule. With an iron fist. I guess that is leading with an iron fist. Well, I have met some people like that, where it's like, I do all the work, because I tell you what to do. It's like, that's not doing all the work, though. I'm doing it. You're just telling me to do it. Or how to do it, or within the fine print of how you want me to do it. It's not exactly how I do it, or how it's done. I forgot to go out and get these guys over here. I think they may have some time. Especially if I cheese them like this. Yeah. Well, run a little bit farther for me. They may not still. They may still be as good as dead. they're already taking the thing over. I don't see any reason to upgrade this again because everyone is leaving on this side. That is your life. That tower is your life. If you fail going to the tower, then you fail at life. Where's your body? That may explain all that. Like, where's your body? You were a team, you're not supposed to be running back alone. Oh, you know, your buddy ran up ahead of you, so you were left behind. Oh, that explains a lot. You were the slow one. Oh, day 5. It should be Red Moon Day. Do we have another close by can? I don't remember. Yes, we do. I don't know if they would make it. Let's find out. Well, the main thing is, I don't know if the Red Moon comes with both sides. I don't know if it's just... Well, no, I do know for a fact it's not just the mountain side, but I have never confirmed if it's both sides at the same time. I've only confirmed it's at least from a portal, at one of the portals at night. Because I have seen one side of the wall get attacked, and I go to the other side and it's not being under attack. So... seems like they come from on one side, so those guys have a pretty good chance on surviving. Let's just make sure I have a good enough chance in surviving. Because we're gonna destroy at least one port. That means they're gonna be upset. So let's make sure you can make it so that we don't have to worry about some things. Not gonna toss another guy right there. Another coin down right there. Because we don't want to accidentally upset them too much. Just two guys is fine, because we're not going to expand anymore. We're not just gonna have them sit right there, we're going to have them sit. Here. I'm just doing this so they have something to do. Hey, you made it. Where was the other guy? Oh, you know what? The other group was separate? Where's the other guy? Alright, well, it's definitely turned off still, so they're definitely only coming from one side. Like, I knew that was the case. Always leave one coin behind. This way that guy can immediately jump on and be like, yeah, I'm back. I'm in this. Let's move up the wall and see how bad we are. Not very bad? Good. Let's put in the defenses then. The bunnies won't like it. The bunnies never like it. It's to be expected. But now, let's see, do we want to... Do we want to keep it one, the two tower high, or the two people high tower, or do we want to keep it the three tower high? I don't think the three tower high is very good, because then the flyers would fly higher than they could shoot. With your bad aim. But it could be beneficial because we can guarantee one extra guy on this side over the other side. I don't think it's that. I don't think you got it wrong. We're just overthinking it. None of the knights need any more money. Let's send them out. They can get to the first one. Yeah, I knew these guys would have money on the way. It's because there's enough fields where bunnies are just constantly spawning now. Constantly putting money down for us. I'm just gonna guide them. Guide the way. Pave the way! Because I poop them right now. Now, the thing is, I don't know which side the horde's gonna come from. I have seen it come from. The portal with the side of the boat for when they retaliate. Nice job there. Just gonna keep one coin there. The good thing about when I'm having bad aim, they may still hit the guys right there. So they'll be able to defend the knights sometimes, because they're bad at shooting. But I've only seen it really happen a lot when you have three knights, because then there's like nine archers that are shooting. So it's nine times the chance that a guy will get hit from coming down. There he is. Welcome to the club that's made for you. Oh yeah. Equip everybody. Bunny! It is assaulting our walls. We must kill the bunny. I don't know if you'll make it back. You're probably just as good as dead.
better run.
You better run.
Let's check the other side. Better run. Anything on this side? Oh, you killed a bunny. Yeah, that one bunny that likes to barrage all walls with fluffiness. Always gotta watch out for the bunnies.
You know what? They're probably attacking the other side. I came out here to take a look, and they're probably already at the other side. Dude, we got one. I felt some lag. Oh yeah, here they are. Oh! Aim upwards! Like, it's not that hard to aim upwards. Oh, I think this is a Blood Moon night too. Yeah, everyone's just gonna turn around as soon as it hits night. It's gonna be funny. You gotta fix that wall faster, man. Yeah, just turn around. We decided we don't want to be out here. Dude. If we lose this wall, I'm blaming you. And only you. The other guy who's helping, I'm not blaming. Because he's at least trying his best to help you fail at your job. I don't expect him to attack the same side. So I'm gonna go around and cook some guys. If they are attacking this side, I should already see them. Here they are! As soon as I said that, I should already see them. Hang on a second, there they are. It's like at that instant when I said that, I should already see them. They're there. It's like they knew. Let's see if they're actually attacking the other side or not. Seeing him repair the wall would guarantee, like, would show us that, yeah, they attacked us. He did repair the wall. So they do attack one side, Stone Red Man? I don't think they did. Maybe they do mage random. Or maybe that was damage from the other attack and they didn't finish it. Whatever the case, who knows? We have to do this. We're not going to get very far without sieging it. And you'd be like, well, it's way too early. You don't have enough money. What if you need to back them up? Well... he's already playing without money then. The thing is, as long as it's still fairly early, the ways won't be as difficult as they would later on. Because the longer we wait, the more difficult the defeat's going to ramp up. And if that's going to happen, then we've already lost. Like I said. Alright, we should have enough meat. Let's just go back and hand everything and just assist them the best we can. Because more likely what's going to happen is a wave will come out while they're running over here, well, over there to the portal, and they're going to need some coins to
pain burst their shields. When we felt their shields. I think that guy fully next guy. Because I have, if for those really far portals, that's what I have done. I follow the knights. As soon as, before they get to the portal, they had to fight at least one or two waves. Before they got to the last portal. Looks like they were fine.
I'd bring a full coin purse, and while they're besieging the horde, I'm like dropping coins constantly on the ground. And either we would push forward slowly, or we could push back slowly. Was that the last portal? On this side? Guess there's the map. And then here's the docks. Yeah, I had to go farther out because I had to make sure it wasn't a bridge, because there are tiny little bridges and it confuses the heck out of people. So because this isn't very long of an island still, we can just toss down that portal right there, and we can teleport all the way from that side to the other side fairly quickly. As you can see how far it's already, and I'm not liking the distance. It's not too bad. Oh, he's gonna go and take the coin, but that's fine. That's fine. Because now we can go out even farther. So now we can use that one farm right there that I'm putting on the wall. And archers, so. And we did put down the catapult, so engineers are still being utilized. We just need one shield. So. Oh my. It's like attack vehicles. Hey, you defended well. And I'm thinking, why did they use the catapult? They did use the catapult. Because it wouldn't die that easily without the catapult. So now that we're gonna start getting some guys, let's start getting some farmers. We did these three farmers. Yeah, he already popped out. That's why you always want to do that. And hey, now we can go to the very end of this island, go and make the other portal by making it come over here, and everything would be good. Also, we can recruit people. We can recruit all the people. I said equipped. I think I said equipped. I remember saying equipped as the wrong word for this. But we're not going to take people and put them on our heads. And Let's see. A good spot for this portal. Let's see if we can get a wave right there. No, because we're too close to this. Dreads. Maybe just enough for us. You came back some time to watch some kill them. Now let's see, do we want to get rid of this now? Or just put a wall and just go from here and go back. So we can't go from next, we need to go even farther out. We need to go from right here and go back. But how close is that? That's fairly close. So if they spawn, they would immediately kill our archers during the day, because they would spawn during the day before it turns night. So they, by the time they get here, would be like almost halfway throughout the night. So, yeah. That wouldn't be a viable option. But you know what's a viable option? Is getting another farm. Yeah. You'd be a farmer. It's your life now. You know you don't want to. If we upgrade this all the way and then get rid of it, we can put down a portal right on top of it. You know what? I think on the first island, they give you a good portion of the boat. I think as a tutorial showing you that the builders or engineers, whatever, the engineer builders will work on the boat. You just gotta put money into it. I think that's where they give you like some supplies. And it's probably just as much to build up the boat on the first one as the second. It's just because you do that lump sum of supplies, it seems like the same amount they're punching into it. But definitely on the third island compared to the second island, even though you get no supplies, it does seem like there's more part that you have to put in. Because you put a lot of money into it already, and you're only working on sticks still to put in it, or the frame. Yeah, at least they're making sure it's more like sturdy and not like half done. Amazing though, they improve on the boat and having to spend more materials on making it, but it's always only getting you to like the one other island. You can only keep like three people on it. So same size boat, it's just better quality every time. So we have 1, 2, 3 sites to go. We can keep easily 5 on it. Maybe 6? I don't think so. We'll see. No one has any other money? Alright. Hey, stop switching your head, just go over here and grab this side. Didn't I have another one here? Did I have one past him? No, there's only 3 guys here still. could have sworn I put another scythe there. Wait, that's because there's only three. I wanted only. I only wanted five there. Oh. That sounds gonna be a big oops. Well, we'll get to see if they need more within another farming spot. Yep. Yep. Just gonna run out and get that next guy. Well, the next, village. I'd come back at night. You know, like, you're like gather right there. Easy, just grab you. Where's my site? Everyone's becoming a farmer. Where's my commerce site? Well, no, you're gonna be an archer. Why? Because I said so. Because I have a big ego issue that I have to tell you what to do. And that includes you. Yeah, I think I want to definitely destroy the next portal. Also get more archers. Yeah, because if we destroy that next portal, we'll be able to, Oh, no. Quickly, someone shoot a bunny. They have a very slim chance of killing that portal by themselves. A very slim chance. Yeah! Yeah! We only had one group on that side. We couldn't send out more guys even if we wanted to. I shouldn't have done that, because I need all the gold points right now. Well, you know, they probably got it, because I'm here. I'm going to defend them. Best I can. Yeah, just shoot the deer. Have you drop the coins into the river whenever you get hit? It's a waste. Oh god, just one part came off. You may be here for a while. Okay, I don't like it when you look confused, like you're like, where's the portal? Where's the enemies? It's like, it's right there. Just keep on shooting. I know you don't have to get your arrows because you're just shooting like two sets of arrows easily. So I know you're not getting your getting ammo is a factor here. You're really good at defending. There we go. I don't know if they would get back. I don't think so. Let's see. Alright, we're at the point where we want to make sure guys defend this. Oh, guys who are just standing around doing nothing. Got some bows. Oh, guys who are waiting so patiently for me. Give me money. You guys, I know you got money too. Thank you. In just case we lose some guys along the way. They make it? Like, I don't see them anywhere. Where are they? I know they're not attacking from the other side because there's no portals on the other side. Wherever they attack from. Oh, there they are. He's just hiding behind the horde of people who are ready to die. And oh, are they ready to die? Alright, more than likely they're about ready to attack. I'm willing to give up all my money to make sure we survive this. Funny! Oh, there they are. Yeah, more money. Do you seriously shoot the catapult for the bunnies? Or oh my god, there's one catapult. No! This is why we left the tower there. This is why there was a tower there. I knew I should have upgraded to level 3. Hey guys, maybe the last episode, because I was dumb. I pissed them off. We survived! But at what cost? I can't even prepare, If they get back to the campfire, they're going to try to disappear on me. So I need to get them coins. And all your crops died. Sad. I have to at least make sure some guys stay with me. At least finish the wall. That's all that's all matters. Just finish the wall. You spend your entire, like, days just, like, repairing that. All these archers were like one button push. Alright, it's obvious to me we gotta get rid of this. And people are just disappearing there. That's sad. That's a good amount to start to cover some of them. So it was the really big guys that made it so we couldn't really survive. Alright, as soon as it hits nights, we can go and try to get everyone's money from them. Because it's a little bit difficult to run out, like, going every single little guy. It's too early for the farmers. Now, tossing all the money out and having them steal the money to reduce their numbers, was that a smart play or a stupid play? On one hand, it's a smart play because now you're guaranteeing that you're stopping people from shooting the capital too early. Now, but the capital shoots and hits like the middle of their squad, you take out all of them, and that means all that money they took was just technically wasted. Well, it's kind of hard to determine that, because if the catapult never misses and hits them straight on, all those guys probably wouldn't have hit the wall so much, and they probably would have survived. But considering we're only, like, day 4, that was day 13 night. I see, it might be day 12 before they started coming at us. And there was, like, 3 of those big guys, like, or 2, usually 2 or 3. And there's no way he could have been that prepared. He killed them all. I think the biggest issue was we had the flyers coming and steal guys away. And then the guys threw the rocks. The easiest way to fix the rock problem is don't have rocks. Because I'm streaming, I'm trying to do this without saving the game and reloading. Because if you save and reload, and there's no rocks on the ground, it doesn't save with the game. Rocks on the ground don't save. It's a good way to clear up entities on the map so that if the game's having a hard time loading everything. I don't know why I'm doing that when I have like a million people that I need to equip. It at least guarantees me that the ogres won't be able to throw the rocks at me. Because they don't have their own rocks, they throw boulders that we throw out there in the first place. Which means if we don't supply them, they don't do that. But is that all problem? Is that the problem? I don't think it is. I think the main problem is the archers just suck at shooting. They don't. And then the catapults don't always hit straight on either. The catapults were always an issue, even with the archer statue, because apparently the aim just sucks. They always suck. Yeah, it's a good time right now, because they're all finishing their harvest. And this guy too? Will you finish it before you fall? Don't look like you're a complete idiot, just whack. Just use your hole one more time. Okay, everyone else. Oh gosh, you need one more use. One more time, man. There we go. Like a professional. Now we can make sure everyone who's not equipped is fully equipped. Yeah, you know what? Let's put this in. Maybe that's what my problem was. We didn't have that top thing. Yeah, I just leave money up there sometimes. It's like, do you even care?
Yeah, let me just walk right out there.
Tippy, as soon as he opens up the door, it's like, nope.
Yeah, as soon as they hit that wall, it's like, they have no other goal. They just want to attack that wall.
I
this, this, and I guess that's it for now. Is there anything else in this area? No. But technically, I don't want to go that far. I just want to just get some more bunnies up here. So we currently got one, two fields. I feel as though we just chop down like one more tree to get like one more. Well, this one. It's gonna open up enough. Don't want to extend all the way down, but we want at least. Alright, so let's have options. We need to put down another wall. Let's make sure we can put down another wall. So, like right here. I mean, that's all we've got. We would destroy that another portal, because we're not going to worry about too much. And you know what, that's smart to go. Just because I don't want, like, I didn't want to sit there and wait. Because I know what's going to happen. This is just going to have to move the tree again. Bunny, grass, more than likely will not spawn from that. It won't be enough. I feel as though we have more than it. But let's make both those guys, engineers. Because mostly I got this bow shot just in case someone loses their bow. Yeah, but look out for that one stupid guy in the group. Someone would not be reading their safety brief information on making sure you're staying in within a curfew hours. One guy coming back late and gets attacked. And it'll be like, see? This is why. Come back in a reasonable hour. The sun comes down. And you don't go outside of the. I guess, like, what? Like, 6 hours walking distance. Four body patches. That's plenty. That's a stupid amount of gold each day. And not including this side. If we get any more people, it's gonna stop lagging, so let's not do that. We got one, two, three patches on this side. Yeah, what? Or that's fine. I don't want to get rid of the people because we get like a bad attack one day. It's technically. We're gonna have to get more people. More likely it would be at a spot that's unrecoverable. But we can hope. We can have optimism. I can be like, well, maybe we'll be that bad. think that would be terrible. Alright, so on day 17, we're setting out the... So that means they're probably gonna get there by day 20. Or just before. It's either on day 20 or before day 20. I'll just start hanging out there at day 20. Oh, I can head over there now. And I can put down the portal. So I can go back up really quickly. Which sounded good. The portal would be nice. We don't have the catapult. We don't have the catapult! Okay, how about we stay back and make sure everything's good? I mean, there's nothing much we could do if it really was bad. What we could do is all the money right here. This way, if they burst through, they'll just take the money. Hey. That's not what that's there for. Gotta aim upwards, guys. Upwards. Mm-hmm. So it wasn't that bad. It was mostly because there was no big guys. Yeah, the flyers are pretty bad, but the big guys are also bad. Mm-hmm. The main problem with having a 3-level high tower, as soon as I think it's like the flyer either be 2 or 3 people, so that means as soon as they grab the people, they're just gonna fly off and not get low enough for the guy at that end to actually hit them properly. So it's probably better that. We don't put in a tower, but I feel that it's better because then if they would have a better chance of getting over the wall. I mean, that's the main reason why I'm doing it. Why can't I put this here? I don't want to put it like right here. I think it would be have to go like right here in between. I don't know. I don't know why it's being picky. Okay, so when that attack happened, 2 guys had a gun. Oh no, you know what, it's because we recruited 2 guys. It's not that we lost. 2 guys had, drop their stuff. Hey guys. Yeah, they're already like almost halfway. Maybe, no. It's probably like a fourth. Slow. This guy needs a break. So one Mississippi, two Mississippi. This should be enough. Oh, he was just gonna stand there for a bit anyways while I do the teleport. Maybe it would have been better to just do that. Let's see if we'll go right here. No. Teleport is starting to get annoying. That is getting annoying. I'm just dropping all my money over here. Alright, so let's try this again. A fourth time's a charm. It only works with third time a charm. Hey guys. Continue being poised. You have to resist the urge a lot to not recruit them. Because if you recruit just absolutely everybody, the game's gonna get slower and slower because of the lag. And it does seem like time. It's frames per minute, it's how fast the game runs, so the slower it runs because it has to keep loading everything, that means time will proceed slower. So if you try to do the 100-day challenge, you really have to keep it where to a reasonable amount of people. Otherwise, it really does there, it's that way. Otherwise it really does like does nothing. Won't get the to the point where you'll be able to actually make it to the 100 days. Because you'll just be waiting for it to load the entire time. And that's what happened to me. I got to the point where I got to like day 50. And I was like just sitting there waiting for, I think it was a good hour for like one day to get done. They recruited way too many people. So I restarted and I kept it at a certain amount of people at all times. And it worked. I was able to get to day 100. The game wasn't super slow, so it loaded fairly quickly. I kept my a backup save of my save file, and so if I died, I just reloaded and made sure I could survive through that day, or do what I need to do to survive through that day. It got to a point where I was doing that several times. To get the 100 day achievement, because it's like, okay, so this wave will break through this wall at this time or in this many days, because the red moon will spawn like 10 flying guys and like 20 giants, and it's like, there's no way I can survive this. What do I have to do to survive this? And it got to the point where it's like, okay, I needed like two of these tower rocks right here, and both of them need to be upgraded to a ballista, and the ballistas just shot the hell out of everything. How is that money staying on? I'm actually quite curious how that's doing that. Oh no, now we're losing all of them. Let's just leave it alone. Let's just teleport. Let's see where they are. Oh my gosh. I bet they're not even there yet, are they? No. Dude, just go for it, guys. Just go for it. Just get the coins. Alright, so... I'm not gonna have you guys sit here and wait. This is gonna be stupid, having to sit here and wait. Because it's obvious that we can survive. But this isn't a challenge for this island anymore. So we can survive the first two... This is the third island. We can survive three islands without needing... Without needing any upgrades. We do have the undead horse, but that's so far the only exception. We haven't actually unlocked anything. The only difference between the regular horse and the undead horse is that... Why am I talking? I was going to skip all this anyway. I freaking did it again. There's that one coin.
squirrel power.
Alright, that's it for this episode, guys.
If you want to save in between the islands, you can. You're gonna have to land, then save immediately. Or you will have to, wait until get to a certain point on the dock. You could just hit escape and hit save immediately. And then when you come back, it would pick up. You don't need to do anything special. You don't have to wait until daytime for it to automatically save. It does save on the beginning of each new day, but that's just in case the game crashes. Alright, Yeah, so see you guys later, and see the start of the new episode.
Bye!